When we have a glimpse of this wonderful structure, we become nostalgic. It takes us to the pre-independence era, a symbol of the beginning of technical education. This is the famous Government Polytechnic at Nagpur. Established in the year 1914 and still maintaining the rich legacy and highest standards of technical education. An autonomous institute of government of Maharashtra, GP or Government Polytechnic, has lots of achievements to take pride in.
This institute has implemented World Bank assisted project under the Government of India in 1995 to 2000. Also, Government Polytechnic Nagpur has implemented Canada-India Industry Institute Linkage Project in 2000 to 2004. The institute became autonomous in 1995, and this institute designs the curriculum, implement and develop the curriculum according to the needs of the industry and serve the society.
It offers diploma, post diploma and advanced diploma programs in as many as 11 technical disciplines. Has testing in consultancy facilities. It was granted the status of academic autonomy in 1995. All the programs offered are accredited by the NBA. It bagged the Narasimha Monji Award by Indian Society for Technical Education in 1996. It was also awarded the Best Polytechnic Award by Government of Maharashtra in 1997, and it is also an institute selected under the Technical Education Quality Improvement Program or TECWIP for overall development.
Presently, the institute is implementing Technical Education Quality Improvement Program of Government of India under assistant. The major component under these projects are academic excellence, networking of the institution, services to community, economy. The main objective of this program is to build technical excellence in India and also to produce the technician at par with the developed country, so that our students can compete in global market.
Spread over a sprawling 22 acres, Government Polytechnic Nagpur has basic infrastructural facilities like well-equipped labs, tutor center for each department, audio-visual rooms, conference halls, language labs, playground, and special cells such as continuing education cell, staff development cell, curriculum development cell, community polytechnic scheme, training and placement cell, and examination cell. The Technical Education Quality Improvement Program or TECWIP started at GP in the year 2005. Rupees 20 million was granted under TECWIP. Specific areas selected for development under this program were academic excellence, networking, and service to community and economy. A CIP or Concise Institute Proposal was prepared for proper planning and implementation, resulting in big achievements under TECWIP at Government Polytechnic.
At the outset, we have received funds worth 2 crores. Most of it has been utilized for purchasing new equipments and establishing new laboratories also. This has definitely added to the academic facilities at the institute. This has been one thing. Secondly, the focus has been on faculty and students development. So overall, the teaching learning process has been definitely helped by the new ventures, and we have been able to take up some new steps which were earlier not there, and we are proceeding only on traditional lines. So I think that has been one of the most important benefits.
A digital language lab was set up with TechWeb funds. It facilitates proficiency and speaking in English.
Listen to David first.
I have been working on tense buster, which has started my grammatical mistakes. That is, I have improved a lot in grammar. Then we have worked on study skill services, which improves our communication skills, that is reading, writing, listening and speaking, which is a major part in which students have a difficulty.
Government Polytechnic Nagpur has purchased 4 softwares, Clarity softwares, which are related to English language. Mostly they are tense busters, study skill success, connected speech and issues in English. And a teacher, without physically going to the student's station, can control and observe from the teacher's monitor. And as well as if the student is doing something else which the teacher doesn't want him to do, she just can lock and control the student stations. This software also has a facility that we can install and store our language related curriculum part, and we can also make the students perform on those part also. Those things are not included in the softwares. Any type of subjects can be taught through this software.
English is a language which can be learned only on the basis of theory. We should be able to speak up, and this Tense Busters, the audio video system, it is helping me in developing my language. It is helping me to speak up more fluently and more confidently.
We have also set up a PLC lab, that is Programmable Logic Controller, which is a solid state device that controls output devices based on input status and a user developed program.
PLC is the heart of any automated industry. So you cannot think of the automated industry without the PLC. As a part of the curriculum, according to the needs of the industry, so we have included PLC as an independent subject in the curriculum of all the branches, whether it is mechanical, electrical or electronics engineering. So apart from training the students in our own branches, we are also training the students from outside. We are also training these faculties from the outside, as well as the faculty, as well as the industry persons are being here in this particular laboratory. So far we have trained 40 participants from outside as well as from the industries here.
PLC is a tool that provides the control for an automated process. Its real life applications are in water level control system, bottling plants, input and output device control unit, stepper motor speed control unit, and pick and place control unit. Campus-wide networking has also been established. This is another big achievement facilitated by TechWeb Fund.
Entire campus is covered and all the computers in the campus are connected to the local area network, and this local area network is connected to the internet. Our campus, we have around 350 computers. All computers are connected to this network.
Modernization of labs and classrooms have been done in a big way with addition of equipments. Reflectorless total workstation for the civil engineering department, image analysis system for the metallurgy engineering, furniture were added in every classroom, cutting machine for applied mechanics, computer labs were established in all departments. This is the library at the Government Polytechnic at Nagpur. Computerized transactions are done here. It also has a book bank scheme. Training programs, study tours, fellowships for staff and faculties have been regularly conducted. Conferences and workshops are also organized. A unique platform has been created to bridge the gap between polytechnics and engineering colleges. This is all through the networking system.
Networking is one of the important subcomponents of this TICWIP. Under formal networking, we had different institutions under the cluster, and we shared faculty exchanges, laboratories, and the visits to respective institutions. Whereas, in case of non-formal networking, we had the institutions which are not in the cluster, so also the industries. Confederation of Indian Industry, under its category of employment initiative, did for a small batch how students should develop themselves for making them employable. We did this 18-day program with the help of resource persons. We exercised this sharing experience and we have learned a lot out of this. In a group that is under the networking component, we progress further and achieve what is our ultimate objective of networking: to attain a global competitive edge.
Naturally, the faculty and the students got benefit of lab sharing and expert lecture through this system. Public service through our organization has always been our strength, reaching knowledge and service, especially to the deprived class, has always been our aim.
Various programs are planned and implemented successfully under this scheme. The unique programs among those are works manager training for Tata Motors, where 21 works managers were trained in first batch, and second batch of again 21 candidates is in progress. Another program is repair and maintenance of TVS Scooty for girl candidate. This program was planned and implemented for girl candidates. Then water, soil and forest conservation and management. So like this, series of programs were planned and implemented in TEQI.
Two-wheeler maintenance, repairs and servicing training program was organized for 40 female candidates with the TVS Motor Company. The best part was all the 40 women thus trained were placed in different companies. All this through Government Polytechnic Nagpur. We also organized a training program with the Tata Motors Limited. Community service programs are run for organized and unorganized sector to update their technical knowledge. Entrepreneurship development and literacy improvement program. Technology transfer was also there, creating awareness, especially in the field of rainwater harvesting, Sarai cooker and solar energy equipments. Training and placement is yet another department which is performing at its best at the Government Polytechnic.
This cell was, prior to TICWIP, was in existence at the institution. But after TICWIP, it has the placement activity as well as the training activity. Both of them has enhanced to the extent from 25 campus previous to TICWIP to 45 campus per annum after TICWIP. Out of 45, I can list few of them. L&T, all divisions of L&T used to come to our institution every year. Then Ashok Leyland, TVS Motors, Tata Motors, these are the few which I can list. With the exception of TICWIP, the tribal development plan was in existence, and under that plan, the downtrodden community students were trained in English speaking. Confidence level has been increased because of exception of TICWIP. We have conducted number of courses for personality development at our institution, one of which is the school which we have conducted with the help of CIR.
Regular group discussion and personal interview programs are also organized for the benefit of the students. Of late, lots of students have been placed in some leading companies through campus interviews.
Kajal Chakole, and I'm studying Government Polytechnic in Information Technology, and it's my third year. And recently I've been appeared for a campus interview which was held in our college itself. And it was a tremendous experience for me. Computer Science Corporation, which is from Noida, they gave me a package of 1.6 lakhs and it was good. And as much as I got support and facilities from this college, it was very satisfying for me for appearing in a campus interview.
And I had been get selected in that campus for L&T from Pawai. I got a package of 2.25 lakh per year.
I have been selected in Hisar from Gujarat. The campus interview was very lucky for me. I have gone selected. I got a package of 1.2 lakh per annum of the training period. After that, it was 2.4 lakh per annum.
The sustainability of the TechWeb project is also very important for us. The funds generated using the resources developed under TechWeb has been distributed into four funds: the Corpus Fund, Depreciation Fund, Faculty Development Fund, and the Maintenance Fund. Rupees 3 lakhs has been deposited in each fund for future sustainability. Under institutional reforms, we have done landscaping and maintained wonderful gardens. Furnishing audio-visual rooms and computer labs, developed methods like recording and reviewing the lectures, and also record maintenance through CDs. The first phase of Technical Education Quality Improvement Program at Government Polytechnic Nagpur was very productive, and naturally, we look back at all our achievements with satisfaction. Given the opportunity, we are sure to put our best in phase 2 of the TechWeb program. We are geared up and are confident to meet more targets and open new avenues for all those who need it the most. We sincerely realize that it would be 2014 when the prestigious Government Polytechnic Nagpur completes 100 years of establishment. And for us, this year is not far away from now. We have a vision, and with every target achieved, every accomplishment, we reassure ourselves, we rededicate ourselves in the service of the institution and to it, to the society and the nation at large.